Hello and welcome to part two of the fire truck. In this second part, I'll be doing the white and red base coat. I've got the materials up on the screen now. Use Sickens Auto Base. And I also included the paint codes for the white and the red, in case you would like to know that. So, the base coat, once again, pretty straightforward. I like to break down any job that I do. I like to break it down into steps. So, you know, in my mind, the sealer's done. It's good to go. I've checked everything out. I can move on to the base coat. So, this is my first coat of base. I did three coats of the white on the spots that needed it, and I did I ended up doing five coats of red altogether. That requires a little bit of explanation, but before I get into that, so this area I'm doing now is kind of tricky. You can see that light there. That wasn't taken off, and I can understand why. There's just a small amount of wire coming out, and that's as far as that thing would come out. So that got masked off, and you can see it has very, very little movement. And I ended up gouging the base coat several times, trying to figure out how to hold that thing without making a mess. I actually, when I was done with my three coats of white, I went back and took some 1000 grit and some 330 wax and grease remover and wet sanded that flat and just kind of hit it up real quick with the last coat. So that was all nice and smooth. Nothing special in this area on the white. I do have the red below that masked off with just a piece of 18 inch paper, just to keep the white from getting on the red, of course. Once again, nothing too special here, just blowing some color in. Excuse me. And here I'm just tacking off, getting ready for my second or third coat. I always do three coats of base, and I might not show that in my videos just to keep the total time of the video down, but you can safely assume that three coats was done on this, because that's just my standard operating procedure, and I think it's a good one to have. So here I'm just taping this paper down. There's a wire actually under there, and the air pressure from my gun keeps wanting to move that paper around. So the white's pretty straightforward, just a couple areas there. The red, on the other hand, it went relatively smooth. I did three coats, and by the time I was done, this took me 4 hours to get the red and the white on. Three coats, 3 to 5 minutes. Well, I would say 3 to 5 minutes flash time, but by the time I got around this thing, I could just basically start over again, you know, tack the whole thing off, do a second coat, tack it off again, do my third coat, and at that point it was the end of the day. So the timing worked out pretty well. The following day was a Friday, and when I came in, my boss was like, "Hey, I want to show you some stuff on this fire truck real quick." So he pointed some spots out that he wanted me to hit with some wet sandpaper. So I went around that Friday morning and just basically checked the whole thing out, nibbed some dust out, flattened some scratches, some light scratches that shouldn't have shown through, but it was more just kind of being safe, because he and I both checked several areas with some wax and grease remover, just sprayed on, make it wet, and see how it's gonna look once the clear coat gets on. And all my blends were good. The light scratches, You know, it's just kind of a common thing with base coat, especially black. If you've ever done black base, you'll see your sanding scratches show through, even if you finish with 600, even 800 grit. You'll see your sand scratches show through. But before you clear, you can take some wax and grease remover and hit your base coat up, and you'll see that those scratches disappear. And same thing with clear coat. Once you spray it with your clear, those scratches go away because that liquid and that clear coat fill those tiny scratches in, and it kind of gives the illusion as if they were never there, they disappear. So in this area here, it's going to be a blend area. That area, it's kind of weird to explain. I was going to do that blend all at once, clear coat the whole thing, and my idea was to stop at that corner, and I had my clear coat and I had a smaller cup with a 50-50 clear and reducer, and then I had another cup with just reducer. I was going to do it all right then on Friday, but my boss suggested that he thought that there might just be too much overspray going on, and just to mask that off in a certain way, and just make a tiny little blend there, because there is a hard line there, and so that's what I ended up doing. It's actually a pretty good idea, you know, having too much overspray in the booth to do a blend like that never really crossed my mind. So you know, you learn something new every day, and that's what I'm all about. So anyway, back to the red. Once again, I'm just going over all the spots that I sealed. This is just the first coat. By the time I was done with my third coat, I was up about halfway blended up on that top part, and I just kind of blew some red paint in on those posts there. I didn't worry about doing the whole thing. And let's see, on that Friday too, when I came in, my boss was like, hey, why don't you just go ahead and blow some red paint up on that top part and go ahead and do the doors too, because I think he was a little worried, and I was too, just a little bit, that my blend wouldn't take, because you know, that's like a 20-foot blend all the way down the side of this thing. And I looked at it with some wax and grease remover, and it looked good. I mean, you couldn't even tell anything was there. The color matched great and everything. But I went ahead and did it anyways, because you know, what if it did show? You're gonna spend some time scuffing and repainting that. So he ordered some more paint, and I spent about 3 hours Friday morning wet sanding dust nibs out, going over everything and getting those last coats of red base on. And I went ahead and did the doors. Like I said, those got, instead of just blended, as you'll see in this first coat, you can see how I blend the doors once I get there. But I ended up just going over the whole doors, because I was almost painting all of it anyways, and we weren't really, where my blends were at, we weren't really trying to match any panels up, if that makes sense. So it actually made a lot of sense to just go ahead and blow some paint over pretty much everything. I left my blends on the posts because those were all right. So everything else just got hit a couple more times. And after the last coat of base, I checked everything out again, and everything looked good. And you can see here, I kind of hit on this in the video when I was putting the sealer on. I should have tinted my primer or my sealer here. I should have tinted it red, because you can see how bright that sealer is making this first coat. And the second coat was a little bit darker. I was actually a little bit worried that the third coat might not bring that color down to where it should be at, but it did. So just something to keep in mind, you know. If you tint your primer, it'll help you get full coverage to the right color quicker, and you use less paint. So, and you know, this project was just so big that it's kind of hard to keep your mind on every little thing. But at the end of the day, it's not really a mistake. It's not a huge mistake or anything really at all. It's just it could have been done a little bit a different way, more efficiently, I guess I'm trying to say. The end result was fine. You know, all the areas that were blended took. There's no weird spots that I could see, or at least when I walked out at the end of the day, there was nothing funky going on. So yeah, that's pretty much how the base coat went. I didn't have any other problems with the base that I can think of. All my paper held up pretty well. I didn't have any paint flaking off that plastic. And even when I did my clear, I didn't have any, I think there's only one or two spots. There might have been only one spot that I had a base coat flaking off of plastic. And that's kind of something else to keep in mind too. if I'm going to be doing a blend, like let's say on a car, if I'm going to be using just a small amount of base coat, I'll just plastic the whole car, just because it's pretty fast actually. You can mask up a car and then cut out what you need to be unmasked fairly quickly. So the thing with using a lot of base coat around plastic is if you start getting a big buildup of it on that plastic, it has a tendency to flake off when you come back with your clear coat. So like in this area that I'm in now, for an example, if I come back over that with my clear coat, it's entirely possible that my air pressure will start flaking that base coat, that red base coat, off that plastic, and it will get in the clear coat, and then you'll have like little chunks or flakes of base coat sitting in your clear, and I don't know any tricks to get that out on the fly. It's you don't want to have that happen, because the best way to fix that is to just let it dry and repaint it. So it's something also to keep in mind. You know, if you're gonna be going over big areas like this with your base, you know, you could plastic everything and then put some of that blue paper, even green paper if that's all you got. The blue paper is pretty nice. It'll hold that paint down. But you know, you could go back and put paper where you, just in the areas you need it. But I do run into a pretty awful problem in the clear coat stage. I don't want to give too much away, but I can't believe, honestly, how lucky I got. It was something I didn't know you could fix on the fly, but I tried it and it worked. So if I encourage you to, after you get done watching this video, swap over to the third final part of the fire truck and check that video out. It happens on my second coat of clear, so yeah, you can check that out. And if the video is not posted up as of now, just hold on tight. I'll get it up. I won't make people wait a real long time. So, but anyways, that's the base coat. I believe I only show just the first coat, and in the clear coat video, you can see I do like a little walk around. So you can see how the final coat of base coat looks. Looks pretty good. Turned out great. And like I said, if you've watched my other videos, I'm real big. I don't move on to the next step unless I am 100% sure that I'm ready, because once you clear coat, to me, that's saying, hey, this thing's done, it's good to go, you know, let's move on to the next project. So, and I know stuff happens, I mean, it's painting, stuff happens all the time, and it's like no matter how careful you are sometimes, stuff still happens, you know, it happens to the best of everybody, so. Nobody's perfect, we're all human. What makes a good painter, in my opinion, is, yeah, it's awesome to be able to lay out that clear coat nice and smooth, but what do you do when you run into problems on the fly? You know, that's a good painter will know what to do, and if he doesn't know what to do, you'll see in my clear coat video, just kind of quick thinking on the fly, and hey, let's try this and see if it works, and you never know, you might be surprised at you might come up with a new trick or something. So I'm gonna leave it at that for this video, and I hope you guys hang around and check out the final painting video. I'm gonna try to get some footage of this before it leaves the shop, after it's all put together. It's hard for me to do that with a lot of stuff that I paint, because I usually just go from one thing to the next. So I don't get to see, you know, somebody's car after it's done, or if I do see something after it's done, I'm like, okay, I need to get some video footage of that, and then the next thing I know, it's gone out of the shop. So I stay pretty busy. They keep me pretty busy, which is a good thing. And they actually do detailing. The detail guy, or the guy who does it usually, they move the car to another building, which makes sense, you know, get it out of the dusty shop and in a bit cleaner environment, you know, while he's washing and buffing and doing his thing. So, and usually after that, you know, if it's like a car, they'll just park it outside until the customer comes to get it. So I'll do my best with this fire truck and anything else I paint to try to get, you know, the final finished version of whatever it is. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Please like and subscribe if you've got the time. I really appreciate it. And yeah, stick around for a while. I've got plenty more videos coming that I think you guys will enjoy. Peace out.
you can't stop me.